G'day, Ben here. With Inductive Automation's ignition pre-installed on the Groovebox, you now have many more options for connecting to popular PLCs. And one of the great things about Ignition Edge is it allows you to transmit data using the pub/sub architecture of the MQTT protocol. In this video, I'll walk you through setting up Ignition Edge for the very first time. I'll cover starting Ignition Edge from the Groove admin, logging into Ignition Edge and changing the default username and password, and lastly, how to apply a license key. Now, if you haven't purchased any licenses yet, remember, you can run both GrooveView with Enterprise Options and Ignition Edge in trial mode for 2 hours at a time. GrooveView with an Enterprise license allows you to connect to OPC UA servers, including the OPC UA server built into Ignition Edge. Inductive Automation's Ignition Edge license activates Ignition Edge in the Groovebox and includes drivers to Allen Bradley and Siemens PLCs, SnapPak controllers, and Modbus TCP devices. If you purchase the Groove Enterprise license, you'll receive an Edge license, so that's the quickest way to get up and running. But if you want, you may also just purchase an Edge license. Okay, let's set up the Groove Edge appliance. Open a web browser and navigate to your Groovebox by typing the following into your address bar. https://your Groovebox hostname or IP address and port 10,000. Log in with your Groove admin username and password. Click on Ignition Edge menu option on the left-hand side here. This overview page will show you the status of both your Groove Enterprise license and if Ignition Edge is running. If this is your first time here, go ahead and select the checkbox to enable and run Ignition Edge at startup. Click Save. Now go ahead and accept the license agreement. And Ignition Edge is now starting up and being configured to start each time now. Once that's happened, go ahead and click Back. Now that that's up and running, we can go to the gateway by clicking Open Ignition Edge, or direct to Edge in your browser by using the URL https://your Groovebox hostname or the Groovebox IP address and :8043. Once you're here, go ahead and sign in by clicking the sign in icon up in the top right corner. The default username and password is admin and password. The very first thing you should do is change these by clicking on Configure, then under Security, select Users Roles. Click on Manage Users, and then go ahead and edit that user. Let's change the username and check the box that you want to change the password and enter the new password twice. Scroll down and click Save Changes. Okay, now let's log out by clicking the sign out icon up in the very top right, and let's log back in with that new username and password. Okay, great. Now, we can see that we're signed in with our new username, so now we can go ahead and apply that license. Go ahead and click Activate Ignition up in the top right corner. If the Groovebox has internet access, then go ahead and click on Activate Online. Type in your license key and click Activate. That's it. That's all there is to it. Now, if your Groovebox does not have access to the internet, then you're going to need to select the Activate Offline option. And just follow the three steps that are outlined on this page. Essentially, what you're going to do is download the offline activation request file and transfer that file to a computer with internet connectivity. Upload it to the URL shown and then save the returned license file and then transfer that file to the GrooveEdge appliance. Now, it's important to note that before you update GrooveAdmin, or if you need to reset your GrooveEdge appliance back to factory defaults for any reason, you should first unactivate your license so that you can reactivate it after the update or the reset. You should also unactivate your license first if you need to move it to another GrooveBox. By unactivating and then reactivating, you avoid having to contact Inductive to have the license reinstated. To unactivate, click on the trash can icon and then click Yes to unactivate. And that's it. The last thing to do is to activate the two modules that are included in Ignition Edge on the GrooveBox. That's MQTT and the Opto 22 Snappack driver. To activate these two, click on Configure up in the top, then Modules on the side under System. Scroll down until you see the two modules at the bottom of the list. Go ahead and click on the Install button next to the module that you want to add. Then confirm that you want to add that module. Scroll down and accept the license agreement. Next, we need to check the box that we accept their security certificate. And we're done. Go back and follow the same process for the other module. So that's it. Your GrooveBox is now fully set up. Check out workshops.opto22.com for other videos that show how to connect your GrooveBox to an Allen Bradley PLC and display its data on your mobile-ready Groove screen, or how to send data to an MQTT broker. Till next time, cheers, mate.